Most of the character animations are expressed through pre-stored rotations of each bone. This method is called forward kinematics. In FK animation, it is impossible to look at or touch a specific object. This is because it is impossible to change the predetermined rotation value of the skeleton. However, inverse kinematics can solve this problem. Unity Animator provides this feature, allowing you to add more functionality to your character's movements. Today I'm going to show you how to make a character look at a target with Animator's IK feature. The first thing we need to do is enable IK Pass in the layer settings of the animator. When IK Pass is activated, an IK mark is displayed to the left of the layer's setting button, and other postures and movements can be added in addition to the set movement. Now let's create a new script and apply this script to the character object to which the animator component is applied. The code that helped with today's example is in one of the Unity docs, Inverse Kinematics. This document contains sample code and explanations of how to apply inverse kinematics in Unity, so I encourage you to take a look at it as well. I will write the code in the same way as the document. These three variables are required, but you can change the number of variables according to your project. To use IK animation, it is essential to use the animator component. If you use on animator IK, a dedicated function of animator, the function is executed without a separate method call. Today's example has only one animator layer, so we won't use parameters. The following code will proceed in the same way as in the document. The strength of set look at weight allows you to scale the movement relative to the target. The size ranges from 0 to 1. If you look at the parameters of the set look at position function, you can see that the target position is set. These two codes are the heart of the day. As in the sample code, if the IK active variable is false, the size of set look at weight will be set to 0. After returning to Unity, we will apply the game object we want to track directly to the object target variable. Before playing the game, don't forget to set the IK active variable to true. With a small amount of code, the character can now look at the target. However, the problem is that the character is constantly looking at the target no matter where the target is located. We can solve this problem by changing the IK active variable, but there is a problem that the appearance changes rapidly when looking at it and when not. Let's solve this problem. First, we will replace the size of set look at weight with a public variable so that we can change the size in real time. If we change the value of look weight, it is confirmed that the degree of looking at the object also changes. So when the target is behind the character, we have to gradually decrease the value of the look weight. Before that, it is important to know the direction of the target relative to the character. I'm going to use the rotation value that occurs when the virtual object looks at the target. First, we will create a game object variable named object pivot. Next, in the start method, we will create a game object called dummy pivot. Since the created game object is located only in the world, we will place it as a child of the character. When we run the game, we see that the dummy pivot game object has been created as a child of the character. However, since it is located on the character's soul, it needs to be lifted up so that it is flush with the character's point of view. Let's change the position of object pivot. Now we need to keep this game object looking at the target, so we will use the lookAt function. All that's left is to create a condition for the character to track the target based on the object's pivot's local rotation value. I was comfortable using the local rotation function, but you can use other functions depending on your project. Let's find out the range of rotation values through debug. When looking to the right of the character, if it is 0.6 or higher, we will stop tracking the target. Conversely, if it is below minus 0.6, we will stop tracking the target. Now let's create a conditional statement. First, let's check that the look at weight changes depending on the condition. When the condition is false, it is confirmed that the character is looking forward. All that's left is to make the look at weight value change gradually. Simply write the lerp function of the mathf function. If the condition is true, we will make it closer to 1 over time from the current value. If time delta time is used as it is, the change time of the value is long, so let's multiply it by 2.5. If the condition is false, the result should be 0. If the target goes behind the character, it is confirmed that the interpolation animation according to the character's tracking stop is applied. If the distance between the target and the character is large, the corresponding tracking may not be necessary. Now let's create a tracking condition based on the distance between the character and the target. If you want to know the distance between two points, you can use the built-in function of vector3, distance. Let's try to figure out the distance for the condition to be satisfied by debugging. If the distance between the two objects is less than 2.6 units, we will make the character face the target. If we place the target close to the character, we will see the character start looking at the target. Conversely, when the target moves away from the character stops looking at the target. If you want to change the condition in which the character looks at the target in real time, let's create a public variable and apply it. That's all for today's video. Thank you. See you next time.